For this particular article, the study team was Jonathan Alexander, professor of English at UCI, Vicky Chen, a graduate student in the School of Education at UCI, and Jonathan Duarte, a high school student on the East Coast, and me. I'm Rebecca Black, an associate professor of informatics, also at the University of California, Irvine. This article specifically focuses on how neurodiversity is represented in fan fiction text written by fans who either identify as neurodiverse or as close family members or friends of neurodiverse individuals. And we also looked at reader responses to these texts. And one thing that we were really interested in understanding was how representations of neurodiversity in these fan-authored texts might be different from mainstream media and fictional representations of neurodiverse individuals. For our methods, this was a diverse study team from very different disciplinary backgrounds and experiences with conducting research. So we began with a reading protocol based on our research questions and our literature review that helped us attend to specific aspects of the fanfiction narratives in a standardized way. And we also used inductive coding as a way of capturing elements of the data that weren't represented in our reading protocol. The findings for the study, as they often are, were complicated. The fanfiction narratives were a mixture of stereotypical representations of neurodiversity, as well as attempts to push back on and create alternatives to these stereotypical representations. But one of the most salient findings was how the online publishing platform provided a space where authors and audience members were able to share their perspectives and contribute to broader conversations around how neurodiverse individuals are represented and treated in society. And that's also related to what we see as implications for the study. Basically, it speaks to one of the many ways that literacy educators can use existing pop culture spaces and digital platforms to engage students in conversations about how they see diversity in many different forms being represented, and what does it mean to represent people in these particular ways, and then to think about how people may choose to represent themselves and why it's important to recognize and honor that.